Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create a Vue project and configure the Vue Gantt Chart component. The Vue Gantt Chart is a project planning and management tool used to display and manage tasks hierarchically with a timeline. Now, I will show you how to configure this control along with a few of its basic features like setting timeline views and task dependencies. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I'm going to create my application using the Vue CLI toolchain. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue, Node, and Vue class component. In the command prompt, I run the command npm install global add Vue CLI. It will take a few seconds to install. Then I create a new project using the Vue create command and provide the app name, my Vue project. Here, I select the option default Vue 3 from the menu. Let's wait for the project to be created. I navigate to the project location and install the Gantt chart package npm install at Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Gantt. Let's wait for the package to be installed. I open the project in VS Code. Before using the Syncfusion components, a license key must be registered. Open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Vue trial license. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, the license key is mandatory in Vue projects to avoid the license warning. To see where to generate a trial license key, check the description below. Next, navigate to the app.vue page and remove the default CSS styles and import the material theme styles into the style section. Then import the Gantt component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Gantt package and register this component plugin to the Vue. By doing this, all the component's child directives are also globally registered. Here, I add the EJS Gantt tag to the template section. To view the basic layout of a Gantt chart, you need to bind a data source. I add the file data.js. And define the hierarchical object. Look at this data, it contains tasks and subtasks. For the first object, I have added the fields task ID, task name, and so on, with appropriate values. You can also see the child object with the same fields. Now, I import this project new data from the data.js file. In the data method, assign this object to the variable data and assign this variable to the data source property. Next, I must map the necessary data source fields to find the project task values using the task fields property. To do that, I declare a variable task fields and map data source fields to the task values such as task ID, task name, start date, end date, duration, and progress. I also map the subtasks field from the data source to the child property. Finally, I assign this variable to the task field's property. Also, I set the custom height to the component. I'll run this application using the command npm run serve. See here, the left pane has a tree grid, and the right pane has a chart with a project timeline to represent the project duration as individual cells with defined units and formats. When I collapse or expand the child records, it will be reflected in the timeline. By default, the tree column index is set to 0. Let's see how to change it to the name column. Set the tree column index to 1. And now, the expand button is shown in the name column. Notice here, the column names are displayed as it is in the data source field names. You can customize the field name and display only the selected columns using the columns directive and column directive. Import the columns directive and column directive from the Gantt package and register them with eColumns and eColumn tags. I add the eColumns tag to specify the details for a list of columns. Then add the eColumn tag to customize a single column. There are more options to customize tree grid columns, but I will show you a few now. I include the field property and map the task ID field from the data source. Next, add the header text property and set its value to task ID. Customize the default width using the width property and align the column data by setting the text align property to right. In the same way, I define the other fields. Apply the custom date format to the column start date by setting the format property. See now, each column displays a custom header. The task ID column data is right aligned, and the date format is applied to the start date column. The Gantt chart has different built-in timeline views such as hour, day, week, month, and year. Looking here, the week timeline mode has the top tier displaying the weeks, while the bottom tier displays the days. To change the timeline view, I add the timeline settings property. In the data method, I define a variable view mode and set the timeline view mode property value to day. And assign this variable to the timeline settings property. And now the day timeline mode is rendered in the chart. The upper tier displays the days, and the bottom tier displays their corresponding hours. Before moving further, I am changing the timeline mode to week. Finally, I will show you how to display task dependency in the timeline. The available types are start to start, start to finish, finish to start, and finish to finish. Notice that the task 4 predecessor is set to task 2. This type of dependency is finished to start. I add the dependency property in the task field settings and set its value to predecessor. As you can see, task 4 is dependent on task 2, and I cannot start task 4 until task 2 is completed. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Vue Gantt Chart component using the Vue CLI command and a few of its basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.